wasallam, if you are going to do haram, then do we expect rahmat in that marriage? Do we expect rahmat in that home? What are we going to expect? So there is no other way out. Let them criticize, let them condemn, let them curse, let them say what they like. But at least a few people must now take up the courage to say that if you are not prepared to accommodate Allah and His Rasul Sallallahu's hukam, if you are not prepared to conduct this marriage in the way that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and Allah are pleased with, then you can exclude me from your list. See, if we will become displeased, say, well, la ta'ata li makhluq fi ma'siyatil khaliq. There is no obedience to the creation of Allah Ta'ala when it is disobedience to Allah Ta'ala Himself. Remember, the heart is the capital of our body. The heart is the capital. My Shaykh explains beautifully. He says that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has made our body like a country. Like a country that has different states, different provinces. So our heart is the capital of that country, of that city. The whole country has provinces. So the provinces of our body, our hands, our eyes, our ears, our feet, all these are the provinces of our body. And the heart is the capital. It's a central government. It's a place for the central government. He says, now if the central government is weak, the capital is weak, then all these provinces are going to be weak. If the central government is weak, then these provinces are going to be weak. There's going to be rebellion. So at present, because of the condition of our hearts, which are spiritually sick and dead, and just like that carcass filled with blood and pus, that is the condition of our spiritual heart. Therefore, we are finding the weakness in our hand, that if there is anything that the hand can take, which is illegal, haram, but if we're going to get some benefit, worldly benefit, then the hand will grab it. If there's anything haram that the eyes wants to see, but if the capital is weak, the heart is weak, then the eyes will say, see, what does it matter? If there is a place that it is haram to walk towards, but because the central government is weak, so the feet will take the person to that place. So he says that the control of the heart is so important. So when there's a rebellion in a province, then what do? They send a military. They send the military to curb the disturbance and to suppress the violence. So that is what we have to do. The heart has to send off what we term as quwwat-e-iradi. So Allah Ta'ala has given each and every one of us a willpower, strength, courage, himmat. And we have to make use of that himmat. Why is it only when it comes to deen, then we got no himmat? But for everything else, we got so much himmat that if somebody says that if you get up 3 o'clock in the morning and you go to a certain place and conduct your business, then you will make hundreds of thousands of rand of business. Then that person got himmat to get up even in the winter morning, is there. So the himmat is there. It's just that because we have got no concern for the akhirah. And Allah Ta'ala has given us food to eat, He's giving us clothes to wear, He's giving us shelter. He has saved us from the tests and the trials that our brothers are going through who are refugees in camps, without clothes, without food, without shelter. So many thousands or hundreds of thousands of them or millions of them throughout the world there are who are going without food, water, drink, whatever little is thrown at them from above by helicopters, they accept it. And they look at the queues of people who had once plush houses and mansions and who had degrees and qualifications, but because of wars or because of floods or because of other disasters, they have now lost everything. So Allah Ta'ala has saved us and protected us from that. So therefore we are abusing this God-given gift. We are abusing it. We are not concerned. As I mentioned in the Friday talk, that if a person is deprived of food for 15-20 days, and thereafter, when he's gone frail and weak, and he's about to expire or depart from this world, at that time you ask that person, that must I bring that illicit love of yours now, or do you want food? Or you are so addicted to those programs and all that evil, then would you like some enjoyment, some entertainment, some music, some fun, some pleasure, or would you like some food? Then he will say, Maro latus, mashukaku. Give me food. So why should we disobey that Allah? in whose hands the treasures lie, in whose hands the rizq lies. He can tighten the screw any time he wishes. And we have seen it happening all around the world. What makes us so complacent that nothing can happen here? And as it is, we are seeing the amount of fear that is being generated in our hearts now, all around us, whatever is happening, how much of fear there is. Even to go for Fajr Salat, it is becoming difficult for so many people. They say it is so frightening to open our doors and come outside. So much of fear has settled in those hearts. When the people were not leaving their homes and going to the masjid, at a time when there was no fear, so they were showing ingratitude to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala for that amn o aman, the security that was prevailing. So because they made kufran a ni'mat,